Fighting fires is something humans have done since times immemorial, but even with such vast experience, it seems our species still hasn't gotten the hang of it. We can't prevent fires from starting, we can't stop some of them from spreading, and putting the huge ones out requires a lot of effort, money, and at times even lives. But what if we could take humans, at least in some cases, out of the equation, by using autonomous technologies? That would certainly remove the dangers humans are exposed to in this fight, but would it be enough to make our struggle more effective? Those are questions we might get an answer to sooner than we think, thanks to helicopter maker Sikorsky and an autonomous aerial wildfire containment technology company called Rain. You might have heard a thing or two about an autonomous Black Hawk helicopter Sikorsky is working on. It's the usual aerial workhorse we're used to, but equipped with some technologies that allow it to fly itself, with no humans on board. The autonomous Black Hawk first came into the spotlight back in 2022, when it was introduced as the optionally piloted vehicle. It took to the sky several times since, including during a demo of cooperative flying in the company of an S-76B experimental rotorcraft. Both aircraft run an autonomous capabilities suite called Matrix. We knew thus that the self-flying Black Hawk is conducting missions aimed at seeing how autonomy can be included in military operations, mostly, but I have to admit I was not aware the same system is being put through its paces as a firefighting tool. Rain says it has been working with Sikorsky on this for over a year, and the results were shown on October 29 at the helicopter maker's headquarters in Stratford, Connecticut. The demo flight, called Rapid Wildfire Response Demonstration, took place in front of people from NASA, the Federal Emergency Management Agency, DARPA, the Los Angeles County Fire Department, and the Orange County Fire Authority. The actual flight of the Black Hawk didn't take longer than 30 minutes, but it was more than enough to prove autonomous aircraft could prove invaluable in fighting fires. The scenario called for the helo to be commanded to take off and head out on its mission using a tablet. The Matrix system guided it while searching for the fire, while the rain-supplied solution, whose details were not announced, adjusted the flight path to keep it Black Hawk on track, even during crosswinds that reached up to 10 knots. The Black Hawk flew with a Bambi bucket dangling beneath it, from which to drop water once it located the fire. Three successive water drops were performed, and they helped put out a propane-fueled fire ring 12 inches across that sent 6-inch flames into the air. The entire flight was supervised by Sikorsky safety pilots, but the Black Hawk flew itself for the duration of the mission and up until when it landed. The test was a success, it seems, as it proved the autonomous systems deployed on the helicopter can be commanded to take off, identify the location and size of a small fire, and then accurately drop water to suppress the flames. The size of the test doesn't make me hopeful that such a method can be used to put out large-scale fires, but it seems like the perfect choice to stop them from spreading unchecked once they get going. On top of that, an autonomous platform can be used day and night, as it needs no rest, and it can also fly in conditions human pilots generally tend to avoid, including turbulent weather, smoke, or bad weather. Estimates are that the US spends some $390 billion each year to fight wildfires and their effects, and that sum is likely to grow by the end of the decade. So, yes, an autonomous firefighter that can put out fires before they really get started could be something huge. Both Sikorsky and Rain seem to be determined to continue their work and are now planning to prove the worth of their approach in more dynamic conditions chosen by firefighters. It's unclear when that will happen, but we'll keep an eye on this and update as soon as we know more. As for the autonomous Black Hawk, the demonstrator will probably be included in other projects as well in the coming years, as all those involved are looking to find ways to reduce pilot workload, improve flight safety, and allow the military to conduct operations in dangerous areas. Although already promising, such solutions are probably a long way from actually being integrated into actual human activities, so there is no time frame for the adoption of the Matrix or other similar solutions for the helicopters used on a daily basis.